All right, I think I'm actually live now. Don't know if anybody will show up, but I thought I wanted to go, instead of filming a video, I wanted to go live and show the comics that I picked up. On Monday, I think it was, I went to my local comic shop to pick up comics, and I've been planning all week to shoot a video, and I haven't got around to it, and so, well, I'll do a live stream instead and show what I got and leave it at that, instead of planning a whole video and filming and editing and all that kind of thing. So, yeah, I didn't pick up an awful lot of stuff. But I am picking up these at the moment. And I can only say if you're not reading these Hill House comics, these horror books from Joe Hill. I don't know if that's his real name or if that's like a, what do you call it, like a writer's name, but it's Stephen King's son. Anyway, this is Basket Full of Heads, issue number 4. And I've absolutely been loving this story. It's horror comics, but this one is quite funny as well. It's got some good laughs in. I've put up all my short boxes here because I'm gonna try and sort them out. And I got some comics that I bagged and bought it a while back that I still haven't taped and stuff like that. So so let's see. I don't know. Oh, it's the Gray Man. Yeah, I was just about to say. I don't know I've never thought about how the comments work, but I think the comments work fine. Yeah, pen name, pseudonym. I was actually thinking of that, but I was because you used that word here in Scandinavia as well, and I wasn't sure if that was the same thing. My Danish bacon buddy, yeah, you know, I love my bacon. Every Danish guy do. Another one from the Joe Hill House comics is The Lolo Woods. This is issue number 2, and I got a feeling that this story is dragging a little bit compared to some of the other Hill House comics. So this one is not moving along as fast as Basket Full of Head was, or as the next one, The Dollhouse Family, which is another one, Hill House Comics. So I got a feeling that Lolo Woods is, with issue number 2, there's not really an awful lot of things happening in this one yet, but I'm sure it'll pick up. I mean, if it's going to be anything like Basket Full of Heads and The Dollhouse Family. Dollhouse Family. Oh, hey, Randall. How are you doing? Haven't heard from you for a while. Hope you're okay over there in cold Norway. Well, I don't know if it's anything like here. It's not cold at the moment. But Dollhouse Family is an awesome read as well. It's about this, just short to explain. It's about this old dollhouse that is being left with someone, she can actually, this girl, she's quite alone, and she gets pulled into this house when she plays with it, and she gets to be part of that doll family that lives in the house, and they got this dark room where you can go in and you can basically kill anyone you want in there, if there's someone you don't like or someone who's doing mean things to you and stuff like that. But I do like, I was going to say that I do like the artwork in these as well. I'm going to try and find something that's not too spoiler-like. But it's kind of different compared to like all the superhero books. But really like that one. And the last one of the Hill House comics is issue number 1 of Daphne Byrne. This one started out really, really good. So I'm looking forward to issue number 2 coming out probably sometime this month. We're in February now. So sometime this month it'll be out, issue number 2. But yeah, as I said, if you're not reading the Dollhouse or any of the Hill House comics, I can really recommend picking them up. If not picking them up issue by issue, then pick up a trade when it comes out. They might even, I don't know if he's going to continue doing doing books or comics for the DC Black Label. So they might even do a collected one with all his stories in there. I don't know, but they're really good. I can tell you that. I'll just get something to drink. Got really thirsty. I got some snacks at the cinema. I just went to the cinema today to watch Bad Boys for Life. I can say this is like the ultimate action comedy kind of thing. It's the way it's supposed to be. It was just awesome, that movie. Oh, that's nice getting it signed by Middleton. That's awesome. Where is he appearing? Somewhere in Norway, Middleton, or are you going to the US and we'll get them signed there, maybe? Another one that I picked up, and I've actually dropped this off my pull list, but I dropped it so late, so I'll get issue number 5 as well. It's Black Terror. This one looked a lot better than what it was from when I read about it in the previews catalog. And it's not a bad comic, but I just feel like I kind of want to cut down and get other stuff that I really want instead. So Black Terror is getting off my list, but the next issue is the last one that I'm getting. MegaCon in the States. That's cool. A friend will be helping to get them signed. Yeah, that's nice. I've actually been thinking about going to Comic-Con in Gothenburg in Sweden in May, because they just announced they're going to have Scott Koblish appearing, and I love these. He's done a lot of Deadpool stuff, and he's done those. I'll see if I can find one quickly. Yeah, there's one right here. He's done these secret comic variants for Deadpool. Well, there's, I think it was every second issue, there was a B cover, and it had like a comic book on the cover that you can follow as well. And he's done loads of them, so I'd love to get them signed. I'm not sure if, I think I might have one that's signed by him. Or was it signed by someone else? I'm not totally sure. I'll put that down later. Another character, I should say, that's really been catching on to me is, or characters, I would say, it's from the Venom stories and Carnage stories. And this one is The Web of Venom, The Good Son, issue number 1. I'm not sure if this is a one-shot. I haven't read it yet. But yeah, it might be a one-shot. Not sure. But yeah, looks good anyway. And I've basically been eating it raw. Everything that comes out with Venom and Carnage at the moment has been really, really good. Issue number 10 of Shazam, another book. DC book that I'm really enjoying at the moment. I know the Gray Man, he will be happy to know that that I'm picking up more and more DC books. Yeah, Bad Boys 2. I mean, Bad Boys 2 wasn't all that, but this third one, I mean, the comedy was on point all the time. The action, the story was really, really good. It was well made. It didn't feel boring at any point. I had some really, really good laughs. This is as close to a perfect action movie that you can get. I liked the movie. Shazam. I don't know if you liked it, Randall, but I really enjoyed it. I've seen it a few times already. That was actually the movie that got me caught on reading the comic book. This one is book number 6 of Batman Curse of the White Knight. I got 2 more issues in this series, and like with any other of the like short series of Black Label, this one is a bit thicker than a normal comic book, and I've kind of been keeping them because I want to read them all in one go. So putting that aside and keeping it when it's over. Marvel Forever. I mean, I'm kind of a Marvel guy as well, but I must say that I've been grabbing a lot of DC stuff lately, and especially the Black Label stuff. I'm normally not like a huge Batman reader or Superman or any of the other like normal heroes, but the Black Label stuff has been really, really good, and they've done some really interesting stories within that. So yeah, you're a huge Wolverine fan. I know that. Next one is Deadpool issue number 2 of the new run. I haven't read this one yet either this week. Because I got to say, I wasn't impressed with the issue number 1 of the new series. It's a new writer on there. Last run was Scott Young that did the writing, and Nick Klein did the artwork, and I really loved that. This one is written by Kelly Thompson, and artwork is done by Chris Bacalo or Bacciolo. I don't know how you're supposed to slaughter his name, but I do it anyway. So issue number 2, I'm definitely going to read it, and being that it's Deadpool, I'm going to pick it up anyway, even if I'm not too keen on it, because I kind of pick up everything that I can get of Deadpool. So yeah, this series is coming to an end. I think it's 4 or 5 more issues of this one, if I'm not all wrong. It's Middle West. That's another one written by Scotty Young. This is awesome. So I think it's only going to be this one run of it, but Middle West I can definitely recommend. It's about a kid running away from home because his dad is kind of being abusive and angry at him all the time, and kind of runs off, and he finds this group of people that he joins and goes along with them, and it's a great story. He kind of finds out that he's like of the same kind as his father, that he's got this anger in him as well. I love the artwork in this book. The artwork is not done by Scotty Young, which is kind of a shame, because I would like to see him do the artwork for this one. It's done by someone called George Corona, or Jorge Corona. Hope he doesn't have anything to do with the virus at the moment. But a really, really good book. And this was issue number 14. And last but not least, I picked up one of the oversized books, which is Question, the Death of Vic Sage, book number 2. And this is a 3-part miniseries on the Black Label as well. So this as well, I'm keeping until I get the 3rd book to read it, because I kind of like these thick ones. I kind of like sitting down one day and just reading all of them, because they're usually just 3 or 4 issues, these miniseries. So yeah, I think you're kind of a completist on the Wolverine, aren't you, Randall? You're trying to pick up a lot of the Swedish and Danish and Norwegian issues of Wolverine, if I'm not all wrong. Yeah, so basically that was my haul for this week. Talking about Wolverine, I do actually have a Wolverine book as well, right here somewhere. I did have two. Wolverine Revolver number one. And Wolverine Old Man Logan issue number 66. And I think this was the first appearance of Old Man Logan, if I'm not all wrong. But yeah, two Wolverine books for you. I think I've showed these before. I picked up a nice haul on eBay a while back, which I only paid about roughly about $13 for the whole stack, and it was a stack like this plus a few extra. I've got two lying here. Two of them was one of them was the House of X issue number one. Deadpool number six from the Scott Young run, and Deadpool issue number five from the Scott Young run as well. This was there was kind of a fuss about this cover when it came out, because apparently Marvel didn't have the rights to do a Garbage Pail Kids cover for Deadpool. So I don't know if that's true, but never got a reprint. But Deadpool the Merc with the Mouth issue number 13, it's an homage to Silence of the Lambs. Spawn, I guess that's issue number 15. Doesn't it say anywhere? Oh well, it's Spawn anyway. I'm not a huge Spawn guy, but yeah, that's what I say. It's a Garbage Pail Kids homage, but I don't think they were allowed to do it. Catwoman number 6. Not a DC book that I actually like. Supergirl number 26. Guess that's an Art Gem cover. Yeah, that is an Art Gem cover. Winter Soldier issue number 2. Didn't have that one. That's the first appearance of someone as well. Can't remember his name, but it's the first appearance anyway of someone. X-Men Red number 2. Had that already as well. Is that Nightcrawler, isn't it? Yeah, it's Nightcrawler on the cover. This one I had as well, Avengers No Surrender issue number 682. That had some kind of significance as well. I think it was I think it was something with like a cameo appearance of the Immortal Hulk, where you just see a hand in here. And then issue number 684 was the first full appearance of no, I don't have the the Virgin cover, unfortunately. Winter Soldier issue number 1. I think I've shown these books before. I think I have done a video on them. And then there was the full run of Die, 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 the surprise comic by Robert Kirkman that came out last year. And I actually have the full run of this one as well, and I actually have two issues already of issue number 1. So I might, as I suggested in the video, I think do a giveaway for these, or even maybe try and sell them, I don't know. But I don't need to, I'm not a hoarder, but no, I don't have the Virgin number 1 of X-Men Red. I would love to have that one, but I don't, unfortunately. I don't normally put a lot of money towards like special covers and stuff like that, and I know that one is kind of pricey. I think that's the ass cover, isn't it? The one where she's showing her behind, the X23 ass cover. Yeah, I got all these books for, as I said, about $13, which was a really, really good deal. There was another Deadpool book in here. The book's lying around everywhere here, so I don't know what that is. But it was an homage to Guns N' Roses, one of their album covers. Anything else interesting I could show you? As I said, I haven't been picking up an awful lot lately, but I've been picking up my pull list. That's mainly what I've been doing. I haven't been doing any eBay buys and stuff like that. Kind of been trying to save my money. As I'm working as a consultant now, there are certain months, especially the months that I get paid. This month I got paid for December, and since there's so many holidays in December, you don't get paid an awful lot because you don't get paid for those days where you don't work. I don't have a Hulk 181, not even the facsimile one. Then again, I'm not a huge Hulk fan, or Wolverine for that matter. I like the characters. I'm not saying I don't like Hulk or Wolverine, but they're not like my main characters, so to say. But yeah, just trying to think of if I had anything else that I hadn't shown, maybe. Nope, not that I could think of. Closer. I need to buy another box for my comics. I need to buy more bags and boards. But as I said, I've been kind of saving my money lately. Here's the rest of the Middle West run. I was falling kind of behind on reading them. So I sat down the other day and I read like 10 of them in one go, but it's awesome. I mean, I can really recommend that story if you're not reading it. Gwenpool is finished now as well, which was another one of my favorites. This is another good story. I mean, kind of, I've been picking up more and more independent stuff as well. And another one is the Gnome and Omen from Image Comics. Kind of an interesting story as well. I think this is only going to be a mini series as well. And and this was a fabulous run. Silver Surfer Black finished a while back. But I mean, if you haven't read that one, pick up the trade paperback because it's awesome. It's definitely awesome. Another Gwenpool book. Another basket full of heads. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, have I got anything interesting in my boxes here that you guys haven't seen? Oh, there's actually some more Wolverine books here. Not that I have a lot, but Wolverine issue number 42. Don't ask me which one, but here's Wolverine. All new Wolverine issue number 31. And Wolverine First Class issue number one. And no, I don't have any Ghost Spider. I didn't pick up that one. I don't know why. I kind of regret that I didn't pick it up, but I don't know why. Okay, volume two. Yeah. see anything else interesting here that we can. I was just about to say, is my X-Men red? Let's see what. Yeah, I just had the regular cover for the first issue. You should have been here in Stockholm like a couple of months ago. I go to a secondhand shop that sells records and comics in Stockholm, and they got in, I think it was 6 or 7 shock boxes full of comics. And there was bucket loads of Wolverine stuff in those boxes from like, I would say, beginning to mid 90s. But I mean, by the time I got there, all the good stuff had been picked anyway. So I didn't pick up any of the Wolverine stuff, but I picked up loads and loads of Deadpool stuff when I was in, and I picked up some Spider-Man stuff as well. Let's see what's in the other pile here that I got lying on my table. Zombies, Resurrection, Marvel. It was an okay read. Nothing great or something like that, but it was an okay read. Dollhouse Family, issue number one. Set this really, really good. Yeah, Randall is American, but living in Norway. So kind of my way anyway, but not all the way there. Where are you actually from in the US, Randall? Absolute Carnage, Captain Marvel. I love the Captain Marvel. I love the Absolute Carnage series, and I'm kind of glad that's over because. It ended up costing quite a lot of money because it was just so many tie-ins. Deadpool annual number one. Deadpool number one of the new series. Terrible, terrible issue. Black Terror number one. Black Terror number two. As I said, it's okay. Not the greatest, but I dropped it anyway because... Basket Full of Heads, issue number two. My Swedish edition of X-Men with the first appearance of Bishop, is it? It's again from Absolute Carnage, tie-in from Venom. Said I'm really eating it raw at the moment. Everything Venom and Carnage, I just I've heard that name Spokane somewhere in some relation. I can't tell you where or why, but Norman Omen issue number three. The Seasoning, it's a new series starting with Deceased Comics again now. This month, I think it is. It's a new short run. Issue number 5 and 6 of Deceased. Have Harley Quinn on there. That's next Friday, the Birds of Prey movie's out. Oh, here's the other Deadpool cover. Comic Core, or Deadpool Core. Core for Life. Appetite for Tacos, which is an homage to the Appetite for Destruction cover for Guns N' Roses. And then the guy that I bought these from, he's on Instagram as well if you want to follow him. He's called Swedish Key Collector, and he has some awesome, awesome stuff to show off there. He's got some great X-Men books and stuff like that, so go and check him out. I picked this. I usually buy some stuff from him when he's selling off, because he takes really good care of his books, and he's got the homage cover from Deadpool to the Nirvana album where he's Deadpool is under the water like the baby. So he's got that waiting for me. Yeah, I especially like the Wonder Woman cover. And then again, I'm a sucker for Harley Quinn. So I know people are slating the Birds of Prey movie, but I'm gonna go and see it anyway because I like Harley Quinn. Shazam. Oh, this was a fun read. I guess I might try and read this and translate for my son because I think he's gonna love it. Peter Porker, Spider-Ham. This was really fun, so I might try and translate that and read it for him. Hey, my Mad Mike's Comics, Montana. God, we're going worldwide now. This is another series from came out of the Absolute Carnage, which is Scream, Curse of Carnage. Loving this series as well. Nomen Omen issue number 4. You see no order in my comics here. But it's everything that needs to be boxed and bagged and boarded. And on here we came to the Lolo Woods issue number 1. Really hoping that's going to pick up like the other ones. Dollhouse Family issue number 2. And Basketful of Heads issue number 3. And you see, geographically, I couldn't tell you where Montana is or where Spokane is and stuff like that. I can tell you, like, East Coast, West Coast, and Middle. But apart from that, I'm really bad. But then again, it's a huge country. What can you say? Anything else interesting to show? Yeah, this was a popular cover from the Absolute Carnage series. Really, really dig that cover. It's one of the Young Guns covers. I tried to pick up all the Young Guns covers, and I think I got all of them except for one. But yeah, it's not going to bring tears to my eyes. I got the regular cover for whatever one I missed anyway, so... Yeah, let's see. What's that? Those issue? No. God, there's so many Carnage books. Yeah, no, apart from that, I haven't really got anything interesting to show unless there's something near Washington State. Well, it. Washington State, I mean, is that anywhere? That's towards the West Coast, the East Coast, isn't it? Washington State. I can just say New York, and then because I've been to New York, I know. The New York's on the east side, and I've been to Denver and Colorado Springs, which is kind of in the middle, and then obviously everybody knows where. You see, it's on the West Coast, obviously. I know California is on the West Coast. I'm actually, I know I just changed job recently, but I'm actually applying for a new job at the moment because it's getting really, really bad where I am now, some things have happened that I wasn't too pleased with, so I'm kind of looking for a new job, and I went for an interview, or had a phone interview, because the guy was located in London, and the head office that's gonna, where the guy who's gonna be my boss if I get the job, is located in Pasadena, California, in Los Angeles. And yeah, obviously I'm thinking of DC, but yeah, that's why. I mean, that would make sense to me that the city of Washington was in Washington State, but oh well, I don't make the rules. but yeah, they said at the interview, because I've done the first interview, I've done the skill test that they wanted me to do. So next week I'm gonna have a video interview with the manager from Pasadena during the evening sometimes. And if I do get the job, they're gonna send me off to Pasadena for 2 weeks to get training. That could be awesome. Never been to the West Coast before. I don't know. I haven't really got anything else to show you guys, unless there's something that you want to ask, if I have anything, or there's anything you want me to show, or something like that. DC is where all the good comics come from. What comics are from Washington, D.C.? I thought the only thing coming from D.C. was politics. Ah, okay. Marvel. Yeah, I know that Spider-Man went to DC not in Far From Home, in the Homecoming movie. He went to DC. Just the DC part. now I get it. Yeah, best comics are from DC. Now I get it. Yeah, see, it's getting late here. I don't get the jokes that quickly. But now I get it. Yeah, they do actually come out on Wednesdays most of the time. They do manage to get them shipped here. So those of us with a pull list, we can pick up our comics on Wednesdays, and then they will like sort out the way it works here is that my comic shop, they don't get every single comic that comes out. So it's not like in the US where you can go into a shop and you can just pull off any comic or variant off the shelf if you want. So I do all my ordering by the previous catalog online. I usually go in every month and I check what do I want from that catalog, and I put in an order for it, so I know it's going to end up in my box at my comic shop. Because they have like a short box up at the counter, and that's the new comics from the last 3 weeks in that one. So you see the amount of comics they get in is not like a huge amount of comics, they get the ones that you order, and you can pick them up normally on Wednesday. Sometimes the delivery do get delayed, and it'll be Thursday or Friday. But since I pre-order all my stuff anyway, I'm not too fussed about it, because I don't need to run to the comic shop when they open up on Wednesday to be able to pick up that special variant or something like that, because they don't get the incentive variants because they don't order like 25 issues of Captain America, or they don't order like 100 issues of a new comic book. So you don't get the incentive variants that often over here. It does happen sometimes, like when a new book like the X-Men came out, the new series of the X-Men, they did order quite a lot and they did get some of the incentive variants, but they usually priced quite high, so I don't pick them up. I don't pick up the X-Men books anyway, but just as an example, so it is a lot different over here. So I can't just go in and pick up the shelf any comic book that I want. So that's why, as I said, I made a mistake with getting the Black Terror book. It sounded really good in the previous catalog, but it wasn't all that good. So I'm dropping that again. So it's sometimes you make misses, and sometimes you find some really good books. I do the previous catalog every month, and I put an order in for what I want. And then I know that 2 or 3 months later, depending on how far ahead the catalog is, I can pick up those books from my comic shop. Which kind of it's kind of nice as well, because it kind of stops this just buying something because it looks cool. So I don't have that temptation that you go into the shop and you see, oh, this cover looks really, really good. I'm going to get that. You kind of have to pre-order if you want it. So it kind of stops that whole thing with just buying because it's there. And I know if I could do that, I would probably spend a lot more money, but I think I'm spending a lot already. And I'm spending nowhere near. Yeah, it's cool, Randall. I know it's late. It's late here as well. I'm going to go off soon as well, but just wanted to explain this till the end. And I probably don't spend a lot on my comics compared to what other people do. I pick up maybe for about, depending on the month, and especially those months where these premium format books comes out, it can be a little bit more expensive. But I pick up for about between $50 and $70 of comic books every month from my pull list. And I don't think that's an awful lot. I know there's people out there that spend several hundred every week or every month. But yeah, I try and just keep it to the books that I really want, and keep it at that. And again, because I haven't got like a huge space here, I can't like just stack up comic books everywhere. I don't get time to read them if I pick up more than I do already. So yeah, that's kind of the way it works over here. So it's a lot different from the way it works in the US. So that would be cool if I went to the US now, if I get this job, to actually see what it's like on a new comic book day over there, and try and go to a real comic shop. Because last time I went to the US, I wasn't collecting comics. So yeah, exactly. I mean, even £100, I mean, that's a lot. I mean, I had my biggest one was last month. I had 3 of these premium format books. I had some of the thicker ones, like the I have one from here. Like off this series, the Batman Last Night on Earth, I had one of those issues, and they're a little bit more expensive as well, as they're thicker than normal comic books. And I spent about $90. Yeah, it's nice chatting to you too, Mad Mike. Feel free to drop in some other time when I'm online. It's cool. But yeah, I mean, I couldn't go any higher than that. I mean, no, that's around my maximum. That's why I don't spend money on like slap books and all that, because I think it's kind of pointless for me, because I like reading my comic books and I like being able to read them, whether they are like rare or stuff like that. So I think the most I've spent on a comic book is on one book is about between $40 and $50. but that was because I really, really, really badly wanted the Batman Damned number one. But apart from that, I don't buy any huge books because I collect to read my books. That's the way it works for me. And I think that's what they're meant to be read. And I kind of collect what I think is fun to read, and not for the sake of making money on it or collecting big key books. If there is a key book in between, I'll definitely, yeah. It happens that there is a key in the Deadpool series or in Shazam or in whatever, and yeah, that's fine. I'm getting it, but I won't go out of my way to get like a special book just because it's a key book. Because I mean, I have two kids as well, and I want to be able to spoil them as well. That's the way it is. You know what it's like being a kid. I mean, you want to be able to give them stuff, and I can't just sit here hoarding comic books and saying to them, oh, I can't buy you this and I can't buy you that. And they see me picking up like a couple of $100 worth of comic books in a month, and they go, oh, why is he picking up comic books instead of buying toys or clothes or whatever? It costs money to have kids. That's kind of my... My explanation to why I do the way I do, that I pre-order all my books instead of like impulse buying comic books, because that would be too expensive. I hardly ever buy anything online anyway, and it's because it's too expensive with the shipping from the US. I don't know if it's the same to the UK. When they ship from the US, it's expensive to the UK as well. I do occasionally buy some stuff from a place in space in London online, because the shipping is fairly reasonable from the UK to Sweden. But that's about it. I don't think that they're worth like. I mean, I've had thoughts about slapping some of my books and getting them CGC graded, but I'm thinking it's going to cost me about $60 it's going to cost me about $60 to get it through my local comic shop. I might do it sometime with a certain book that I have this first appearance of Immortal Hulk, and I got a reader's copy of that as well, like a B cover of that one. So I might slap the A cover because it's a really cool cover, but it's nothing that I'm really aiming towards that I need to do. And as I said, I don't have any slaps. I'm one of the few people in the YouTube community that don't have a slap book, but I'm not really fussed about it. I really want to go in the shop. Next time I'm coming to London, I'm definitely going there. So yeah, we should meet up then. I know I'm going in. I'm going in September, beginning of September. I'm going to London for. Probably be 3 to 4 days because I have a wedding to go to. One of my friends is getting married, I'll be in London by then, but I'll let you know before, and if you're free, we can definitely meet up and do a place in space together, go grab a beer afterwards or something like that. That would be fun. It's around your birthday. When in September is your birthday? I just had my birthday 2 weeks ago. Didn't get anything comic related. I got the only one that gets me presents now is my mom, and she usually gives me money. And I don't know if you saw on my Instagram, my one rule with the birthday money is that I buy a Lego set. So I bought the Batmobile, the small one, not the huge one, for like $300. I bought the small one for like $30. Hey, comic book G-spot Galvin. Yeah, overseas, yeah. We go online sometimes as well. Oh, the 5th, that's actually around the time that I'm going there. I'll see, I think the wedding was, see, September. God, I think the wedding was on the 5th. Let's see. That would be so cool. Yeah, I'm going to a wedding on the 5th of on the 5th of September. So yeah. I'll find that that book or the car. Oh well, I managed to drop the Joker. Yeah, it's this one. So that's pretty cool. So yeah, that's my I don't buy a lot of collectibles and stuff like that, but my one rule is that the birthday money that I get from my mom, we made it as a joke a few years back that I should go and buy a Lego set, and I went and bought the Wall-E that I have. And then the next year I bought the Ghostbusters car, and the next year after that I bought the Penguin car in Lego, and now this year I bought the Batmobile. So yeah. No, I think he dropped his gun. That's about the only thing. Yeah, he dropped his gun. That's the Joker. So, definitely. I think I might be, because I have the kids that week when I'm going to the wedding. So I'm trying to maybe even get my ex to take the kids a few days earlier. Or if not that, then I'll get my mom up here and she'll have them for a few days. yeah, I think I might be going on the Thursday. After work, I'll be flying over and then staying until Sunday and going back on Sunday. So I'll probably, maybe the Friday or the Sunday, we'll meet up for a quick one. That would be cool. What do I like to collect? I like to collect my comic books. that's about the only thing I really collect. I do have some stuff over there in the, on the shelves, like Lego sets and figurines and stuff like that, but I don't normally go out and buy figurines and things like that. Only if I find it on flea markets and stuff like that. I don't have anything around here really, except for the I've got a huge Darth Vader up here, and the Buzz Lightyear and Deadpool, but. Yeah, definitely. Well, which comics I like? Well, my main focus on in my comics is Deadpool. I'm a huge Deadpool fan. I've become a huge fan of the DC Black Label as well. So I was mainly a Marvel guy, and I picked up mainly my focus is on miniseries and the Deadpool. So I don't really collect a lot of huge runs. It's more like I pick up those where they do like, oh, it's five issues of something, like this one. I'll take this as an example. Like an example is the Killmonger that I have. So these ones that I can just, I can take out these one day and I say I'll read these as a just because I like them. And so mainly it's miniseries, Deadpool, and DC Black Label. Yeah, Deadpool is cool. I don't like the new run though, but yeah, the Morbius movie looks really, really good. I'm really looking forward to that one. I'm looking forward to the Black Widow one. I'm looking forward to the New Mutants one as well. Those are my three go-to movies for this year. Apart from so many other movies coming out this year, but those are three that I really want to see. But mainly miniseries, and occasionally I pick up something different. Like I'm reading this Middle West one that I really enjoy, and I had another one of these. Image comic called Gnomon Omen, which is another independent one that I'm reading, but. Yeah, I mean, especially the Black Widow movie. I really, really think when it comes to the Black Widow movie, I think they should have done that between the two Avengers movies here at the end. Instead of stressing out the Captain Marvel one, they should have done the Black Widow one. So you kind of had the backstory of her before she died in Endgame, and then they could have spent a lot more time on getting a proper Captain Marvel movie out, because I honestly do like the Captain Marvel movie, they could have done a lot better. They could have done a lot better if they had more time with it, I think. Yeah, the new Hellboy movie was actually quite good. I like that that actor, the one who's in Stranger Things as well. I can't remember his name now, but the guy who plays Hellboy. But I didn't mind the Captain Marvel movie either. I mean, it was good entertainment, but I just think they could have done it better if they had more time with it. Silver Surfer Black Prestige Edition. That's one I really, really badly want. I have the miniseries of Silver Surfer Black, and I absolutely loved it. Loved the story, loved the artwork. I know a lot of people didn't like the artwork in those in that one, but he is. He's Red Guardian in Black Widow. That's right. Can't remember his name now, but it doesn't matter. He's good. I like him, though. But yeah, I'm kind of surprised they're pulling out Red Guardian, but I guess that's because it's kind of But I mean, Amazon, the shipping is going to kill it for me on Amazon. I sometimes look at books or comics on Amazon, and the shipping prices from the US from Amazon is killing it for me. I mean, sometimes if there's a special issue that I'm looking for, let's say that I couldn't get this Middle West over here, couldn't find it anywhere, I would order it from the US. One comic book from the US cost me up to between $20 and $25 in shipping from the US. Yes, he is kind of Marvel's version of Superman. I know, but I think they could have done the movie a lot better than they did. So I'm guessing you didn't like the Captain Marvel movie then. I just, as I said, I thought it was okay. It's not the best one. It's not the best movie, but it's not the worst one either. So. Exactly. I mean, even $16 shipping is a lot. I mean, it's I mean, if you're just buying like one or two books, yeah, I do actually have music in the background. Can you hear the music that clearly? It's very, very low. Scarlet Witch, I mean, she really got me in the Endgame movie. I've never really been a big fan of Scarlet Witch, but I think it's because we haven't seen her real powers at any point. But when she showed her real powers in the Endgame movie, I was like, what the hell is going on here? And it was just amazing. That scene still gives me like goosebumps. I love that. Yeah, it was 99 Luftballon with Nina. It's some radio channel that just plays 80s music, so. Was 99 Red Balloons. Now it's George Michael. I'm not a huge fan of him, I can say that, but yeah, I mean, I think it's just, I mean, because he's been in other Avengers movies before, and it's just like, why have they never showed why have they never showed Scarlet Witch her real powers like in other movies? I don't know why, but I really enjoyed the way they did it in Endgame. Yeah, she did both the English and German versions of that song. Here they usually play the German one. I guess that's closer for us. Let's say that we learn German in school and stuff like that. So I guess that's kind of. I even grew up with watching German TV because that was. When I was a kid, we had two Danish channels and three Germans. So I watched a lot of German TV when I was a kid. Anyway, we're going past the hour now, and I think I'm gonna jump off for today and probably do another stream in a few weeks when I have the time again. Probably got some stuff to show. But it was cool having you around, and especially Galvin. I haven't seen you around here before, but it's cool you dropped by. I think she went too close to Thanos. Think she should have nailed him, like really. She should have. Would have been nice if she was part of killing him, but I knew it was going to be someone who did the that the gauntlet that would be able to kill him probably. But yeah, it was nice to hang out. It was cool having you around here, and definitely drop by another time when I'm online. I'm not online that often, but try and drop by when I'm here. It's cool chatting to you as always, and it'd be really cool to hang out in September when I come to London. We really have to. Really have to sort that out. That would be fun. We should get the other UK guys down there, like JPL and Comic Geek McDee. But I think they're quite a, well, at least Comic Geek with these quite a bit from London. I don't know how far York is from London. We should get JPL down there as well. Be fun, like a small gathering of the European crowd. So, yeah, but anyway, guys, thank you for dropping in, and I'll see you guys around, and take care and read some really cool comics.